Hi there, how's it going? This is Ash and a warm welcome to my latest video to come on my channel. This is another wee video of a how-to, and this will be a tutorial on how to change your traction tyres over. And the model I will be using is another Class 60. This one is 6100, and the reason I've chosen this one for the how-to tutorial, for the reasons being, is that, as you can see on there, the traction tyres have worn out and this one has almost disintegrated. So what I've done, I have purchased a bag of traction tyres which will fit most, if not all, Lima models with the standard wheels, such as this Class 60 and the HST that I've already done. So what you're going to need, just to get access into the model, you can need some screwdrivers, as you will be removing these two screws on the bottom to access the motor and to remove it from the chassis. As I find, this is a lot easier to work with rather than keeping the bogey onto the frame of this model. So what we're going to do, just going to pick two wee traction tyres here, and these are intentionally smaller than the other ones, and for the reason that is that these will have to be stretched over the wheel itself in order for them to stay where they are. And the reference number for the traction tyres is X9721. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to pause the video momentarily. I'm just going to move this box to one side whilst I dismantle this model train, and then we'll have a look at the wheel sets. And just before I go, I'm just going to move that track out of the way, as that was left over from my reviews, and I will be doing a review later on anyways. But that's it for now. I'll be back once I've dismantled the train. And now I have removed the screws, as I've omitted them out of the video just to keep this video more interesting. It's just a matter of removing the bogey frame and placing it somewhere safe. I tend to place mine upside down so that the screws do not fly off and become lost, as that does save a lot of time when repairing and putting the model train back together. So the next thing to do is to just ease the motor out of the frame, and just be careful not to snag any of the wires. But here is our motor bogey, as we do have a traction tyre there which is worn out, and there is none on here. And what you'll have to do is, when you put the when you put the traction tyre on, is make sure that there is no kinks or twists in the tyre, and make sure that it is flush against the inner wheel. As you can see there, I usually work from the front and I'll just slide it round onto the actual wheel itself. And as you can see here, the previous owner has used quite a lot of grease and, I think, crude oil, something like WD-40. So what I'm going to do, just going to have a wee look at that traction tyre. And as you can see, not sure if this camera is picking this up. Now I'll just turn it. The traction tyre is not creased at the front, although there is a slight kink at the back, so we just need to press on it and make sure that there is no knotting at all, as it will affect the ride and the handling of the model train. So what we need to do, just need to push this down very slowly, ease it onto the wheel, and that should be all there is to do with this traction tire. So I'm just going to pry this down. I will cut some of this video short, or I will add some background music whilst I'm doing this, because this is quite a time consuming job, and it will take you about around 10 to 15 minutes to get this done. And it doesn't really help the fact of the matter is that the previous owner has kind of smothered this in gunk. So what I'm going to do, just going to pause the video whilst I clean my hands, and I will return in a moment. Now I'm back, and I did cut the video short there, for the reasons being is that getting these traction tires to onto the wheel can be quite a bit of a challenge. But just for comparison's sake, here is the old one, which is stretched and worn, and these are barely visible as they are very tightly wrapped round the wheel there. Just going to move this chassis closer to you, as I still have greasy fingers and I don't really want to get this horrible gunk onto my camera. So I'm using my three clean fingers to start and stop the video. But I hope this will help. So basically the procedure is to put in a new traction tire onto these wheels that are the outer axles. Start from the bottom and then slide two fingers and overlap it. And then just press round just to remove any creases. And that's all there really is to this simple how to change your traction tires. And I have cleaned some of this horrible gunk off this motor bogey as well. And I think the previous owner used something like a WD-40 or some unsuitable mineral lubricant anyways. But personally, I use the Gauge Master oil or sewing machine oil, as they are much better for lubricating these plastic gearing and stuff. But we'll see how the train performs once I've put it back together. So what I'm going to do, just to show what it looks like now, and I'm going to put the train back together off camera, and I will show you the finished product when I return. Now that I have reassembled the Lima Class 60 back together, just to show what I've done, here is the new traction tyres, and these are thinner than the originals, and this should give the Class 60 enough traction to pull a suitable size train. Although, don't expect this to be as powerful or as heavy as the Hornby Class 60, but traction tires do make all the difference on these older models anyways. So that's all there really is to this how-to tutorial in terms of changing the traction tires over. And what we're going to do before I bring this video to a close, I will be doing a quick test run on the inner line, although there will be no background train on this occasion, but I will be doing a review after this anyways. Now I have the train on the track, in this case my Lima Class 60 that is numbered as 6100. Let's just apply some power to the track, let's see how well this train performs. Currently got that on 50% power. and I may have to wake this one up. I may have to turn it down once the motor warms up, as I don't use this model train very often. But as you'll notice straight away, the traction is much better, as there is a slight hill on this track that the Class 60 has to climb in order to pass this station, as the floor in this apartment is not level by any means. But there is no background train, so this is just to show the benefits of changing worn out traction tyres for new ones. And that concludes my video. I hope this how-to tutorial will be helpful for those of you that are new to model trains. But that's my method on how I change my traction tyres anyways. You could always use two cocktail sticks to run the tyre over the model trains will, if that would be easier, but I just use my fingers, as I'm more of a hands-on person. And to be honest, I prefer to do it that way anyways. But anyways, that concludes the video. Thank you for watching. Take care and cheerio.